10th of June, a month short of his 33rd year, Alexander's great heart finally gave out. And as he bowed, he joined Hephaestion. But in his short life, he achieved, without doubt, the mythic glory of his ancestor, Achilles, and more. His sacrifice was an early death, but in keeping to his side of the bargain, I cannot help but feel he conquered death as well. Olympias' transgression in the murder of his father is, to my mind, a probability. His, a burden. Alexander was too in love with glory for him to steal it. But by blood, and blood alone, he was guilty. Within hours, we were fighting like jackals for his corpse. Wars of the world had begun. 40 years, off and on, they endured. Cassander in Greece, Craterus and Antigonus in Western Asia, Seleucus and Perdiccas in the East, myself in Egypt, until we divided his empire in four parts. Cassander certainly proved his will to power when 7 years later he had Olympias executed. And within 12 years, he achieved
the complete destruction of Alexander's bloodline when he poisoned Roxana and Alexander's 13-year-old son, the true heir.